We're here at the Bramwell Junction Roadhouse. We just stopped here for a quick bite to eat and then we're off to the Telegraph Track. So it's what we've all been looking forward to, isn't that right, guys?
Yeah!
Let's go! Woo! We've finally come to our first creek crossing. It's just called Palm Creeks. It's going to be interesting because I'm going to be towing a trailer down this lot. Never done anything like this before, so let's see how I go.
Awesome.
I can do that with my thongs.
Okay, who's first?
Oh, the turtle will make it.
Yep.
So we brought all the guys down there. They seem to be a little bit more uneasy about it than I think what they expected. So we're going to try and work our way around it. Because no one wants to go down that one this time.
Hang on, that's not quite right.
Well, do you want to go down there?
I said if everybody else will follow me, I'll go.
This is easy, this one, Bek.
I'm not doing that, Stan.
Why?
I can't tell if you're serious or not.
This is it, this is it, this is it. Okay, what about this is the easier one?
Dude, can really? Find, it's that easy, is it?
Can you find another one?
I hate to see a hard one, if that's an easy way.
That's it, keep coming. Straighten up. Yeah, maybe that's coming out.
To the left a little bit. Left, 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 left. Okay, now right.
Put on the brake.
Yep, just gentle, gentle. Just ease it down. Go. Ease it down. Over to the right a little bit. Remember we've got our trailer on. Ease it down. Putting the brake.
Yep.
Ease it down. Ease it down.
Yep.
Go. Ease it
Palm Creek. I was a little bit nervous, but I'm absolutely stoked I did it. First go. Let's see what's up next. Next creek we got coming up is Juicy Creek. Hopefully it's not too juicy.
left, left.
Coming up is North Alice, so let's see what this one brings us, because the other last two, they brought everyone a bit of a surprise by the sounds of it. So let's see.
Gentle, gentle.
Yeah, I've got
that
vehicle hanging
underneath. That's it, you're down. You're down.
Gentle,
gentle, gentle.
Are the mudguards
going to
make it?
Nah, gentle, slow, 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 slow. Real slow, real slow. You're on the edge of it now. Slow. That's it. Burst it out. Just a bit of a straight.
Love bite.
It's a baby love bite.
Just went over the North Alice. Doesn't look like too much when you just stop up and have a quick look, but she's got a little bit of a drop just before the water's edge, so you know, first low, definitely. We're up here at the Delhunter River, so this is where we're gonna spend our next night. Let's see what it's got to offer us. It looks already quite beautiful. We're up here at the Delhunter River. This is, as I said just before, we're gonna spend our next night here. Got fresh water, pools to swim in, can't wait to jump in. These little guys are called pitch plants. And what they do is they actually eat the insects. On our last video, Paul, known as Thargaminda Man, he's actually shown what they actually do, but they're everywhere up here. So they keep Cape York clean, keeping all the bugs out.
Huh? That's cool on the water.
don't have to go up here. Can't go up there.
What?
Can't go up there. Oh, that's silly, Stan. That's impossible. Which one do I pick? That one or that one? I think this one.
Look at that. You can't go up that one, definitely not.
Yeah.
So it's got to be that one.
It doesn't look like much has been up there though, Stan, does it? not recently, in the last year or so. Hey?
Stan likes to tell a bit of a lie sometimes. Don't have to go up either one of these. Even if we were, he'd be driving up them because there's no way in the world I would. Crossing we got coming up is Birdie Creek. It's a little bit more of a strategic crossing. It takes a little bit of thinking and working out to do. So once you come across, there's heaps of holes through it. So you just got to pick your track and, you know, pick that to the left and just keep on your right. You miss all those holes, otherwise you might get lost in them as well. Instead of the campsite, you'll get lost in a hole. So we just did Birdie Creek. That was one that I was just talking about a little bit before. It's got all the little rocks in it, so you got to be careful when you're going through there, because if you take one wrong turn, you can either end up the creek or you end up busting your tire on the rocky holes there, because they're quite sharp around the edges. But then the one after that is Gunshot, so that's one of the most famous crossings to do on the Telegraph Track. But also, if you don't want to do that, you can take the bypass road, which is that way. And please just take note of this certain little sticker here, because these guys are legends.
Well done.
Oh,
Slide there. Oh. Right over. Oh, don't go that way. Yeah.
Notice all the terrain around here, it's all quite flat. It's called heathlands. This is what you go through just before you hit gunshot.
You're not going? Hey, guess what? You've got to go all the way back. No, tell him to go back.
Actually got stuck, so they were just trying to winch off this tree over here, but it's not straight enough for them to be able to pull the rest of the car out, so we told them to move it up so it's more directly in front of them. Hopefully it'll be easier for them to get out.
That winch not working?
So we tried to winch this car out forwards and the rope snapped off the drum. Snapped it off.
Go, 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 go! Woohoo! on short track of the tracks. So he's gonna give it a go, let's see how he goes. He's got a car behind him holding him back. Hopefully he makes it through safely. See how he goes.
Look.
Well, that was an experience, wasn't it? Gunshot was a lot more hectic than what I thought it was going to be. A couple of the guys, younger guys that were actually not in our bunch, but another bunch, popped their tyres straight off the rims. They were gutted by that lot. But that was definitely an experience. I'm just glad that we had Stan, and obviously I'd like to also thank Mike and Bruce for putting in a lot of hard effort today, helping us all get through. Thanks, guys. Cockatoo Creek. The water seems to be running a little bit fast. Just going to go down and check it and see how deep it is, and then we'll see how we go make it across.
I'm a travelling
much harder than the beginning of it. finally arrived at Fruit Bat Falls. Look how beautiful it is.
Yeah, that's it, just like that. Keep it going. Yeah, stay over there, that's good.
Scrubby Creek. There's a fair bit of water in there, so when you come through, you come kind of down to a little bit of a dip, a little bit of a drop, and you got to stick to the right hand side of the track. So that way, you know, once you're up against the bank, it's always gonna be a little bit more solid than right in the middle. But it wasn't too deep, so we didn't need a water bra because it was just below the door. Get a bit of a look around, and then this is our first creek crossing for today. So this is Canal Creek. So we're only going to do a few today, just because the guys don't really want to take their cars to the deeper water when we head up further north. So we're going to head back onto the Bemagar Development Road.
Thank you.
back on when you go across. Slow, slow. Slow. Slow.
Bad. A little bit of water in there, quite a few little bit of drops, they just sort of pop out of nowhere. We discovered those ones. So we're just back on the Telegraph track now. We're just going to head off towards the development road because the rest of the tracks, there's been too much water that's come through this year. So it's just not worth it to bring our cars through. The guys aren't too keen about taking their cars through all the deep water. We're just back on the Bemiga Road now. It's quite a different road to the road that we've just been on. It's much smoother, much more comfortable, and everyone's back. So we're just making our way up to the Jardine River. I'm going to cross over on the ferry, and then we're going to drive down to where the old crossing used to be and see what they used to have to go through. Jardine River. We just had to stop and pick up our tickets at the BP servo just there. The hours to pick up your tickets is only between 8 and 5. You can't pre-book them either, so make sure that when you get here, you get them. Prices have gone up too as well, so just keep an eye out for that one. Just come to the old crossing that you used to have to use when you used to cross the Jardine River. So this will be the end of our Telegraph track for this trip anyway. We just didn't want to, you know, go the rest on the Telegraph track. As I said before, there was too much water, didn't want to damage the cars. This is obviously was where they used to do all the crossing, but you can't actually do it anymore. There's been a big tree that's been obviously pushed down to block it. It's obviously too dangerous for people to try and get through.